All right, guys, this is it's a white frisé again. I'm getting ready to do three rooms in a closet. Using microfiber to clean with. The house is in the middle of a showing right now, so I'm gonna try to be quieter if possible. I'm gonna probably show some of the cleaning in this room here. Let me show you it room by room, basically. I'm in here and they're out there, so I'm gonna just concentrate on this room right now. We'll have a look at the other two when I get over there too. All right, everything has been pre-sprayed. And it's already looking quite a bit lighter here. Should turn out really well, even though it's a white frisé. The dirtiest is right over here. This is already lightening up too. So I'm gonna get started over here and I'll pick up some of the cleaning when I get about in this area here. we'll groom that, come back and have a look. All right, now, get this guy all done in here. Camera hanging up in the extension cord. All right, I'm not gonna put another footprint on it. Well, I may, I'm gonna close those windows over there a little bit later. Let's go take a look at the two rooms up front now. I've already kind of pre-treated them for spots. I haven't pre-treated the whole room yet. I've got to do that first. All right. This room here had some stuff in it that I didn't pre-treat that, but there was some other stuff that I already knocked out basically with some ammonia. So that one there. And in here, treated that area and that area. I'm gonna hit those a little harder and get that ladder out of the way right there. So anyway, I'm gonna pre-treat these two guys and then come clean those, and that will finish up this job. Three rooms pre-sprayed, and that was the master bedroom I just did right there with that one. Everything has been pre-sprayed and groomed in now. There's a guy that I've been meaning to get back to earlier in the week that was doing entirely too much. I've been meaning to text him back, but hopefully if you're watching the video, he was pre-spraying, agitating with an Oric, pre-spraying again, and then running a Challenger over it. I think in the last 19 years that I've been doing this, I think I've agitated once with the Oric just to kind of see what I was going to get. You know, I don't, it's not necessary, you know, unless you're in like just a complete, you're trying to clean a complete dirt floor or something, basically. When you're doing a frise like this, basically you want to groom, with a grain groomer, you want to groom your pre-spray in, so your pre-spray is touching all sides of the fiber, so it's dwelling on it properly. The machine itself, while it's orbiting, it's going to do all the agitation that you'll ever need while it's extracting the soil. So, too much pre-spray can cause wicking, and you don't want that. And you're making a job take entirely too long, making it more difficult than it needs to be. So I've been meaning to text the gentleman back, let him know that. That's gonna get a little more ammonia on it here before I begin in here. But anyway, I think I'm probably gonna clean this one, and then we'll do like before and after on this one, and then we'll probably clean that one together maybe. At any rate, I'm gonna take care of this one now. All right, this guy here is done. Turned out really well again. Just had to take my time since it's a frise, and it seems like the microfiber by itself tends to be enough. So I'm thinking in the future, it's weird how I've gotten a bunch of frise here lately. Everything seems to be frise everywhere I show up. So I'm getting to try something a little different on every one. It's rare that you have that much repetition in one carpet fiber, but here lately, that's how it's been. Last Friday, I was doing a frise, and he saw me tear into it with two different cotton pads, and then finally one of these microfiber. Well, it seems like taking your time and going increasingly slower with a microfiber produces a better quality cleaning than doing more steps, it seems like. At any rate, this one here, I'm gonna move the camera around the room while I clean, and we'll get to see a little closer here. Of course, the machine is gonna be probably shaking the camera at some point, but we'll just have a look at exactly how slow that I'm cleaning. You know, I'm not in a hurry by any means, and you can do a horrible job cleaning this way as well if you're in a hurry, and I'm not. You know, I'd much rather have each job be, you know, kind of like a showcase rather than do a bunch of work and have it all subpar and look like hell. And you know, I wouldn't be as busy as I am now if I did subpar work people weren't happy with. Thank you. it's coming out really, 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 really well. Over here, basically right in this area here, and then over there is where the real troubled areas were. So I'm gonna go through those right now. And then of course, right here is where all the traffic is. So that'll be a place to watch. Know what to attribute it to. I think the fact that I'm doing so many different small things that add up to a better carpet cleaning rather than just doing just one thing. Several things I've done a little different on this job, but between the two different canisters of pre-spray that I started out with, I can't tell you exactly what's responsible for what. So anyway, you know, the amount of difference between different cleaning solutions are very slim. Assuming we can see what just happened there. Sure hope so. Yeah, cleaned up really, really well. The one thing that I have been doing consistently that I think is worth doing is I soak my bonnets in a certain amount of the pre-treatment before I begin with them. So the bonnets have the cleaning agent on it as well. right, I'm gonna groom it and we'll come back and take one more look over everything that I've done here. All done now. Let's go take a look at what all was done. This is where I started. It's the master bedroom. I'm gonna go over there and put those drapes back down where they belong here in just a second. And then over here, these two rooms that I just finished. I'm gonna take a few pictures and text them to the guy that sent me out here. This is a client that has several different rental homes and his own management team that manages them. So probably text a few pictures over. All right, guys, appreciate you watching. That finishes up my Friday. Tomorrow there is two cleaning jobs. They're cleaning and a repair, I believe. And then Sunday I took on an absolutely huge job because the business is closed. It happens to be Easter Sunday. The business is closed. And I normally wouldn't work Easter Sunday, but I'm at a place right now where my mother is in a nursing home, basically in a independent living type situation where you can't visit her right now with all this COVID-19. So I'm not gonna get to spend it with my mother, and all of the parks are closed where you can't go fishing. So I'm just gonna work. So that's what's gonna happen tomorrow. And I've got a helper, luckily, because if I didn't have a helper, it would either just almost kill me, or it would take an extremely long time on Sunday to do that. It's a floor that it's an epoxy coated smooth gravel finish. So they're having new epoxy applied, but they needed to have it cleaned before the epoxy is put on. So basically I'm going to clean it and have it neutralized so they can put new epoxy on and have it actually adhere. So that's what's going to come up on Sunday. So while everybody else is doing something fun for Easter, I'm going to be doing some flooring. So at any rate, the money that I make off of it should cover up the pain that I'll have in my back when I finish up the job. Hopefully that's how that'll work. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. If you have questions, you know the number is 512-350-1129. Have a good afternoon and God bless.